Monday on an all-new Inside Out. Say goodbye to 1995. And get ready to discover a whole new year of backstage Disney secrets. Join JD to find out what goes on to make the New Year's fireworks go off with a bang. Go behind the scenes with Brian and jam with the Jammeters. And be there with George Foreman as he takes on some tough opponents at the Neverland Club. So check into an all-new Inside Out, Tuesday at 8:30, 7:30 Central on the Disney Channel.
Welcome to Walt Disney World Inside Out. The weekly show that keeps you up to date and takes you behind the scenes at Walt Disney World. With your hosts, Brian Leary, George Foreman, and J.D. Roth. This week featuring New Year's resolutions from some of your favorite celebrities. And now, coming to you from the home of the Tower of Terror, Disney MGM Studios, a warm welcome for J.D. Roth, Brian Leary, and a special guest.
Thank you, Minnie. Let's hear it for Minnie. Give it up for Minnie.
Yay, Minnie.
Bye, Minnie.
Oh, love those shoes.
What an outfit. Very well dressed. Hi, everybody. I'm J.D. Roth.
And I'm Brian Leary. Welcome to another edition of Inside Out, the show that shows you the show behind the show at Walt Disney World in Florida.
Easy for you to say.
Well, barely.
And once a month, the show behind the show at Disneyland in Southern California.
We're going to keep you up on what's happening around the parks.
Well, Brie.
Yeah?
This is it, okay? This is a brand new Inside Out, and I got to tell you, I am totally stoked.
Stoked? J.D., what is stoked? Where do you get that, and aren't there doctors looking for a cure for it?
Okay, I don't know. I mean, I can't help it, you know?
Yeah,
I'm
right.
At Disney MGM Studios. Mm-hmm. I got all my friends around me. I'm with my lovely, charming, well-dressed co-host.
Okay, you left out Vivacious.
Vivacious?
Vivacious. Okay. Just keep talking.
All right, okay. This week, we're going to go to Pleasure Island for some incredible entertainment. And our co-host, George the Big Guy Foreman, is going to get us into one of Disney World's most exclusive nightclubs. You're going to love this.
Very cool.
Your kids don't like it when you're leaving with a sitter? Well, they'll love it when you're leaving with me at the Neverland Club. Cute kid. Ah. Oh. Ah.
George is the best. That's right.
No one like George.
And on top of all that, it's almost New Year's Eve.
Whoa, now, J.D., you've actually got me sort of stoked.
Oh, nice try, Brie.
Okay, I'm working on it. Okay, we're also going to have lots of celebrities tell us their New Year's resolutions.
That's great, but why just celebrities? I mean, there are people here from all over the world. Why don't we hear their resolutions? You know, like the people in the audience.
Okay.
Who's got a great resolution for next year? Anybody? You do?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm coming back.
What's your name?
Pat Murphy.
Pat Murphy, where are you from?
Newport News, Virginia.
Virginia, and what's your resolution?
Come back to Disney World.
You gotta love that. She's coming back to Disney World. This guy, you had a resolution. What's your name?
Oh, my name is Patrick, and my New Year's resolution would be not to miss any more episodes of Inside Out.
Man, you know, you're sharp. Oh, I like that.
Thank you.
And I like the haircut, too. It looks
it
good.
Works.
Who else has a resolution? Anybody have a good one? What's your name?
Amanda Yasalonis.
All right, what's your resolution?
To stop fighting with my sister.
Oh, that's so nice. Of course, it'll never happen, but that's really nice. That's a lot of resolutions. See, my New Year's resolution is a little bit more simple. It's to see as many Orlando Magic games as I can this year. So hopefully I will. All right.
Okay, so since it's almost New Year's Eve, I can't think of a better place to get things started than at Walt Disney World's Pleasure Island, where it's New Year's Eve every night. Oh, here comes my designated driver.
Great view from up here. Look, you can see everything. Magic Kingdom, Epcot. During the day, Walt Disney World is a playground for kids of all ages. But when night falls, where can an adult go when they want to party with kids their own age? There it is, off to the right. Pleasure Island. This is Pleasure Island, the heart of Walt Disney World's nightlife. They've got 10 movie theaters, good eats, great shopping, and 7 totally awesome nightclubs. Okay, so it seems kind of quiet right now, but when the sun goes down, this place turns into 6 acres of full-tilt, wall-to-wall party. In just a few hours, the Neon Armadillo Music Saloon is going to be packed with people doing the achy breaky and that tush push thing till the cowboys come home. And then there's this guy, not sure what he's doing. Maybe it's the achy tush push. Okay, so you bring the confetti and meet me back here around, oh, hi, this is my good friend Lou. He works on the 3rd floor here at Mannequin's Dance Palace. Okay, so he seems a little stiff right now, but trust me, he's really gonna come to life tonight at Mannequin's. If you like dancing, you'll love Mannequin's. Not only are they spinning the latest tunes, they're spinning the dancers on the dance floor that's actually a turntable. And here at the Adventurers Club, you can decipher some hieroglyphics, discover the unknown, or every 10 minutes or so, you get to Kungaloosh. If you want to explore the unknown and discover the impossible, or have a few laughs with friends, check out the Adventurers Club. Okay, so we already know that every night is New Year's Eve here at Pleasure Island, but the real one's coming up, December 31st, and this place goes wild. So I'm here with a wild and crazy guy, Mr. New Year's Eve himself, the general manager of Pleasure Island, Tony. So Tony, what do you do special for New Year's Eve?
Well, like you said, we do New Year's Eve here every night, and the other 364 nights are our rehearsal. We've got name talent all over the island in 4 major venues. This year with 38 Special, Eddie Money, the Fabulous Thunderbirds, and Sophie B. Hawkins.
Wow, that's great.
We think we've got something for everybody.
So what happens at midnight then?
At midnight, we do our New Year's Eve show, which is really plussed with a ton extra of fireworks and a confetti storm like you've never seen.
Oh, that's so great.
It's very cool.
You know what? I'm from New York, but it sounds like you guys almost top Times Square.
We think we give it a good run for its money.
And he's not kidding. Okay, so there's a lot to get ready. We're counting down to party time. We're gonna come back here later tonight, and this place is gonna rock. Happy New Year from Walt Disney World. My resolution for 1996 is to stay happy and spend a lot of time with my growing family.
Big George, right? I mean, this guy is fearless. Not only will he trade punches with 250-pound heavyweights, but he'll go toe-to-toe with 50 rowdy kids at the Neverland Club. That's the nighttime daycare center here at Disney World. Why don't we go to George's corner and see how the champ is holding up?
I'm helping out here at the Neverland Club where the kids at Disney can have a night away from their parents.
Are you sure, George? These kids can be a handful.
I was rope-a-dope by Muhammad Ali. These kids are no more than a day at the beach.
Hi, kids. I'm George Foreman. I'll be your babysitter and cut man for the evening. Now, let's go over the rule. Rule number one, have fun. Rule number two, hey, kids. Hey, kids. Hey.
Can we get the ball? Right, Cindy?
Fries. Oh boy, chicken, hot dog, pizza. I'm gonna have it all.
Is that all?
Oh, George, you know you have to eat that all up before you can have seconds.
Oh boy, are you gonna eat all of those french fries?
You think I should keep it in T-bills or invest in mutual funds?
You can't go wrong with CDs, George.
Oh, thanks a lot, guy. I appreciate that. Kids, that's not the way that we do it. We don't fight. We share around here. There you go. That's the way we do it.
My dad says you can't take a punch.
What? Here, kid, this is for you.
George, how many fingers? George?
Be like without fireworks? Well, it would be like New Year's Eve without fireworks. But come on, they'd never let that happen at Walt Disney World.
Hey, what's up? I'm catching a ride with the fireworks crew. We're gonna go find out what it takes to put on a show. See you over there.
Now first, we gotta think safety, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so we've got the safety sunglasses. I'm gonna put these babies on. It's a nice look for me, I know what you're thinking. This is a mortar shell?
This is a mortar tube.
Mortar tube.
And these are the shells. And one of the first things we wanna learn is when we load these shells or when we go near it, we don't lean over the tube at all.
How many tubes are there on this truck?
There's about 150 tubes on this truck. And they're various sizes, as you can see, 4, 5, 6-inch shells.
How high do these things shoot up into the air?
Well, basically, based on the shell size, if it's a 4-inch shell, it goes about 400 feet.
Five-inch shell, 500
feet. You got
it.
Huh?
What do we got here in this box?
We've got an assortment of shells of just about every type and description.
What will this one look like once you detonate
it? It basically makes large circles of colored fire in the air.
What is this?
This is a shell that's marked white flitter cross set. When it breaks, it throws out a large crown, as we say, of white flittering comets. They will each individually split. Total effect of that look in the sky is one of crossing tracks of fire.
Look at the size of that baby, huh? Set that off in your backyard, you got problems. How many shells are you planning sending into the sky?
Probably between 1,000 and 1,500 all across the parks.
This is the squib wire, and it is the way that the shell is ignited. It goes to an igniter on the bottom of the shell where the lift charge is. Unwind the wire, place the shell over the tube, and we use the wire in this case to gently lower the shell into the tube, and we hook it up inside here. And the electrical impulses are shot out to the trailer, and they systematically fire the shells wherever the shells are designed to be in the show.
When you look up in the sky, after you've set 100 of these things off, and everything's exploding in a big finale, what kind of feeling do you get?
Exhilaration, and I hope the audience feels the same way. If I've done my job right, they will.
My New Year's resolution is to make sure to stop and smell the roses. And if you don't have time to stop and smell the roses, you can stop and smell the chocolate. Now, my favorite chocolate is, if it has nuts and raisins, well, I'm pretty happy. Sometimes you get chocolate that's white chocolate, that's okay. But my dark chocolates, well, those are not my favorites. But if I'm gonna smell anything, if it's dark chocolate, I say go with it, you know what I mean? Now, raisinettes, see, raisinettes have chocolate and the smell of raisins. And if that's what my New Year's resolution is, then I'll smell raisinettes.
This week at the Disney MGM Studios, America's number one movie comes to life in the Toy Story Parade, currently marching down Hollywood Boulevard with daily performances every afternoon.
Everything here at Epcot, in fact, everything here at Walt Disney World is an act. They've got acrobats, magicians, mimes, and that's just in the ladies' room. But you're not gonna believe this next act. They actually make a show out of taking out the trash, and they call themselves the Gemeters. volunteer with the Geminis. What were the other names that you maybe thought of?
A whole bunch. Let me see.
Epcot Trash Harmonic.
Yeah, yeah.
Litter Feet.
Litter Feet?
Yeah, the Red Hot Litter Packers.
Red Hot Litter Packers. Yeah. That was going to go over real good.
Stand still. Stand
Many techniques that are used to create the absolute possible techniques and tangents that
right.
you use to create the different sounds and melanges and various and sundry.
Somebody shut him
really?
Up.
Okay. Yeah, really?
Yeah, well, speaking of that, I hear there's a popcorn spill over the monorail.
So, popcorn spill!
I got it.
Go!
Ben Savage.
And I'm Ryder Strong.
From the show Boy Meets World. And my New Year's resolution is to probably be a nicer person, be a happier person, be a more giving person, be a good guy.
My New Year's resolution is probably just to seize the day more with my life.
Seize the day.
We're heading over to the Magic Kingdom for a trip through Adventureland, where you can climb the treehouse of the Swiss Family Robinson, brave the man-eating lions of the Jungle Cruise, or enjoy a chorus of crooning cockatoos in a tropical serenade. It's also where you'll find one of Disney World's most popular adventures.
Ah, the Pirates of the Caribbean. This was one of my favorite rides when I was a kid. I mean, hey, who can forget the song, right? Hi, diddly-dee, a pirate's life for me, a la 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 la.
That's the song from Pinocchio.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Oh, okay, thanks. Yeah, okay, well, he caught me, right? I got to admit it. I've never been on the Pirates of the Caribbean. When I was a kid, I thought it was too spooky, too scary, and I've got this unnatural fear of parrots.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a parrot's life for me. Ah!
So, for my New Year's resolution, I'm going in, overcoming my fears, going on the Pirates of the Caribbean. Because I'm bad. Let's go. We can do it. It's just a little parrot, right? No big deal. Whoa.
Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me. We're rascals, scoundrels, villains, and knaves. Drink up, me hearties, yo ho. We're devils and black sheep, pretty bad eggs. Drink up, me hearties.
All right. So it's not so scary. Especially since I got an after-hours tour from a pirates expert. This is a great way to see Pirates of the Caribbean. I'm out here right in the water.
Yeah, and about 29 inches of water, that's about it. It seems so much deeper, don't it?
It does. It does. When you're on the ride, you think the water goes forever. And what's controlling the water shooting out?
Well, these are cannon bursts. Did you see that?
I sure did.
All they are is big, long tubes down in the water. And they set it right at the water surface. Water fills the tube, and on a cue, air comes up through the bottom.
Stand back.
And that was meant for you.
Whoa. Look at this place. Hey, these pirates really know how to party.
With all these animatronic pirates going nuts down here, you gotta wonder how they keep them under control.
What be I offered for this winsome wench?
So what happens when, you know, one of the pirates goes a little bit haywire and starts to fly his arm and move his head sideways? How do you guys fix that?
We use this called the black box. We can address any of the functions of the auctioneer. He has 25 functions total. For example, this address is set up to make his right arm forward move. And by moving this back and forth, you can full extent or full retract. And if you turn that dial, it can make his head nod, his mouth.
Okay, pirate, say ah. Just a little trip to the dentist.
So do the pirates go all night?
No. Matter of fact, we're gonna put him to sleep right now. Dax Central, West 4, can you night mode cards for me, please?
Roger. Night Thank mode. You. Well, good night, big guy. Have a good rest. Yo-ho, yo-ho. Now, that wasn't too bad, right? These pirates really know how to party. I'm so glad I made it. I went on Pirates of the Caribbean, and I overcame all my childhood fears. Hey, who knows? Maybe this is the year I'll get rid of my nightlight.
My New Year's resolution for 1996 is to come back to Walt Disney World, stand in this exact same spot, and make my New Year's resolution for 1997.
Is just getting started over here at Pleasure Island. And here to kick things off tonight is a band that's taken us back to the 60s and the British invasion, the Mahoney Brothers.
You say that you love me, say you love me all of the time.
Celebrate the new year at Disney MGM Studios with a live performance by Huey Lewis in the News. Next month, January 19th through the 21st, watch the best of the ladies' professional golfers compete for $450,000 in the inaugural LPGA tournament at Disney's Lake Buena Vista Golf Course. January 21st through the 23rd, join science fiction stars Leonard Nimoy, James Doohan, and Marina Sirtis for Disney's first ever international science fiction convention at the New Tomorrowland. Later this season, January 26th through February 25th, Chinese New Year's kicks off a month-long celebration at Epcot with special entertainment and authentic festivities. January 27th, IndyCar racing roars into Walt Disney World as they inaugurate the brand new track near the Magic Kingdom.
Okay, this is it. The moment we've been waiting for. It's almost midnight. The last few seconds of the year are ticking down. Get ready to say goodbye to 1995 and hello, 1996.
That's right. They're going to be partying all over Walt Disney World.
Counting down at the Magic Kingdom, rocking in the new year at Epcot, and rolling in 1996 at Disney MGM Studios.
You know what? I can't think of a better way to see this. The end of 1995 than with a few thousand of our closest friends.
And if they weren't our closest friends now, they will be in a few minutes.
The end of the new year coming round. Everybody, counting down. 20.
Yeah.
you guys have a happy and healthy new year.
Happy New Year!
And we want to welcome everyone to the new year 1996.
And we'd also like to thank all the people here at Pleasure Island for helping us bring it out with a bang.
Happy New Year, Bree!
Happy New Year, everybody! Yeah.
For your free copy of our vacation planning video and a complete calendar of Walt Disney World events, call us at 1-800-354-2500.
Accommodations provided by Disney's Port Orleans Resorts.